Students, now we shall study how t-ratios are defined, that is, what do we mean by sine, cos, etc. For this, we shall define all t-ratios of an angle A in triangle ABC. Correct? So, in triangle ABC, we have taken this triangle ABC, it is right angled at B. So, for this angle A, okay, this will be the opposite side or perpendicular, this will be the base, okay, and the side AC would be the hypotenuse, which is the longest side. So I can mark AC as hypotenuse, perpendicular, which can be represented in short as P, as BC, and base as B. Okay, so this side AB in short can be represented by B, which is the adjacent side or base. Okay, students, first t-ratio is sine of angle A. Okay, t-ratios are always defined for some angle. Okay, when I say sine alone, I apparently mean that I have taken a ratio of the perpendicular and hypotenuse with respect to an angle. Okay, t-ratios have a complete meaning when they are taken for some angle. For example, here we have taken sine of angle A. So, sine has only the complete meaning when it is taken for some angle. Okay, so the first t-ratio is sine of angle A. It is defined as the ratio of side opposite to angle A to hypotenuse. Okay, so side opposite to angle A is BC and hypotenuse AC. So sine of angle A is equal to BC upon AC, which can be written as P upon H, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. And in short, it is written as sine A. When I say sine A, I mean sine of angle A. Okay. Likewise, we have defined other t-ratios. Second t-ratio is cosine of angle A. It is the ratio of the side adjacent to angle A to hypotenuse, which is equal to AB upon AC, which can be written as equal to B upon H, that is base upon hypotenuse, and in short, it is written as cos A. Again, cosine of angle A means cos A. Okay,